Yes, sir, we promised you a great
match. Gorgeous, good.
Here we go. Classy, the maker of
comedy. The champ.
WrestleMania.
WrestleMania is running wild.
The Royal Rumble match. 40 superstars. One winner. The prize? A main event championship opportunity at WrestleMania. One winner. A who's who of WWE superstars. What makes this match so special? Let's count the ways.
Six. The Deadman, The Undertaker, the record for the number of victims eliminated by the feared Deadman in a single Rumble match under the WEDF banner. The Phenom also holds the most time for being in a Rumble event, at 18 minutes, 27 seconds. The Straight Edge Society leader CM Punk on the underhand wasn't as fortunate as the Deadman, as he was only being in the Rumble at 52 seconds, the shortest time for any competitor being in the Rumble. This year, will anyone break that dubious record? This is first year a Rumble event took place. Danny Jackpot came out the victor, as he won the first ever Rumble match in WEDF history. Will history repeat itself? Which number brings the most of fortunes? That would be the number 27. Four men have won the Royal Rumble via the 27th selection. Tonight, will that number once again lead to success?
3. Stone Cold reigns in Royal Rumble match wins with 3 grueling victories. And with an unprecedented 40 WWE superstars making this the biggest Royal Rumble match in history, the numbers mean more than ever, both the highs and the lows. Number 1, a definite disadvantage, where time is not on your side. Yet a number that has produced the same amount of winners as the number 30 spot.
John Cena has won the Royal Rumble in a huge shocker.
This year, there will be 40 superstars, but there can only be one. Who will prevail to earn a shot to headline WrestleMania?
I was never the kind to be taking my time in a place that's worth a damn.
There's only one road to WrestleMania, and it begins at the Royal Rumble.
And now, WEDF presents the Royal Rumble.
Ladies and gentlemen, the road to WrestleMania begins tonight. We welcome you to the second annual Royal Rumble pay-per-view. This is Frank Dog, joined alongside Wally, and what a night we have in store for you tonight.
The atmosphere is electric, Frank Dog, and I can't wait to see the 40-man Royal Rumble here in WEDF.
You've already commentated one, it's time for another one here tonight. 23,000 on their feet, ready.
Here we go with our first matchup of the night. The United States Championship is on the line. And here comes the champion, MVP.
Montel Bontavious Porter who's been known to sneak his way out, keeping his United States Championship tonight. The odds are stacked against the Ballin' Superstar. It's
going to be an interesting matchup as he comes along. One of my close friends, man, Eichorn, and some other guy.
Booker T. Triple threat match. This all began at Survivor Series when MVP got Booker T counted out. MVP's been sneaky his way against Booker T. Eichorn won a number one contender's battle royal to earn a shot. Management decided to see the way that it all fell out, with Eichorn giving both Booker and MVP steel chair shots. The management decided to make this a triple threat match.
Gonna be a really interesting matchup, and of course, MVP in a triple threat, he could lose his title without even being pinned. That's the disadvantage of being in a triple threat match here tonight.
That's a good point. And here he comes, one of the challengers, Booker T. I gotta say, this man is ready for tonight. He's ready to kick MVP's teeth down his throat.
I'm ready to see Booker T here tonight. Of course, he was way back the WEDF King of the Ring winner.
Yes, and then lost that spot to Kofi Kingston after his King of the Ring and Kofi's Money in the Bank were on the line.
It's going to be an interesting matchup here tonight.
Booker T, a former United States champion, won the title at King of the Ring earlier in the year, beating Kofi Kingston.
That's right, but he lost it shortly after that to The Miz, the very next Raw.
Maybe Booker T has a chance to regain that title of the night. Will he?
Or could it be Eichorn's big win here tonight? After only holding the TV title and tag team titles here in WEDF.
Now you can say that Eichorn's U.S. title win will be the biggest of his career. It's something he's been pursuing for a long time. Not past the antics of Armando Estrada holding him down for one of the most dumbest reasons.
That's right, and also he seems to be the bigger man between Booker and MVP. He has that size and strength advantage, but also he moves really, really fast in the ring for a guy his size.
That's correct. Anyway, this on Raw, Eichorn and Booker decided, you know what, we're going to team up on MVP. He's not worthy of this title. And then all of a sudden, after Eichorn and Booker threw MVP out, after MVP escaped, Eichorn gives Booker a cheap shot with the United States Championship. So it's going to be every man for himself. Eichorn said, the hell with that.
And a statement that he won that WEDF United States Championship here tonight. There we see the gold waves up high. We've seen so many great competitors hold that WEDF United States title. The Miz, Suspect, Booker T, MVP. So many great names have held that belt.
Shawn Michaels, Matt Hardy. And here we go, this match is underway. Three-way bout.
Both men just out. Yep. We see a stare down now between Matt Eichorn and Booker T. MVP wants no part of it, just gonna stay outside the ring, maybe.
I'm MVP, that's wise strategy.
Yep, that is a wise strategy. Just gonna
MVP
let them
playing the edge role from Backlash 2006 with Triple H and John Cena, looks like. He's staying out of the way. Here we go.
And Eichorn trading blows now, each blocking each other's punches. And oh, Eichorn comes up with the big haymaker.
Triple threat match for the United States Championship underway. Eichorn with the knife edge chops.
Booker T now coming back. A couple of chops of his own. Huge punch there. Irish whip, Eichorn reverses.
Oh.
Nice lariat.
And now Eichorn, oh no, here's the power game of Eichorn. You say he's the biggest man. This, for a reason, the power game coming into play.
That alley-oop style power bomb. Irish whips him into the turnbuckle. Booker T managed to counter out. Nice shoulder thrust right there to the ribs and a huge lariat there.
What a shot of the clothesline. You see MVP not hesitating to get in the ring. He's taking his time.
He can stay out there. He can just run in if there needs to be to break up a pinfall maybe. But he can just rest up, I think.
But Booker T reverses. Oh, what a shoulder thrust in the corner.
As I said earlier, that's the champion's disadvantage in a triple threat. He does not have to be pinned to lose that United States title here tonight.
The Eichel was in the Tree of Woe. That was something Eichel was not used to being in. I've never
seen a common drop him.
A Booker whipping him. And no, nice heel kick. We can see that flexibility and the clothesline.
Looks like he's trying to build momentum, see? And there's MVP. He managed to grab Icon's arm, put it on the ropes, call the rope break. That was a very interesting strategy there by MVP.
Oh, Icon ducks. And oh, Booker T called him. What a power slam.
That was a huge power slam. Amazing strength there. And there we see it again, MVP. Just interrupting pinfalls. Letting the two competitors beat each other up, and then he's gonna come in and pick up the scraps, it seems. Nice heel toss there by Eichorn. Again, huge strength advantage over Booker T.
Eichorn with a kick to the gut. What's he thinking here? Oh! What a knee.
Now he's gonna put Booker T in the Tree of Woe.
Booker T gets out of it.
Has to catch that foot.
Oh!
Another huge power slam. Now he's gonna go for a pinfall, it seems. MVP quickly managing to break up that pinfall. Now just trading blows. MVP, I think, finally has decided he will engage in this match, maybe. Just gonna stand on the ropes now, it seems.
And look at Eichorn and Booker T have stopped punching.
I think they've started noticing that MVP has not been in this match even. And finally Eichorn gets him with a slap straight across the chest.
And Booker now. The double teaming begins. I think Booker and Eichorn have had enough of MVP.
What's Eichorn thinking here? Gonna go for that alley-oop. Oh! Head bounced straight off that steel ring steps.
An MVP might want to regret trying to take a breather throughout the whole match and not even get involved.
And again, MVP's head just bounces off that steel ring post. And Eichorn with the huge haymaker punch straight to the head again.
Here we go with more double teaming. Oh, nice chop block.
The chop block, of course, MVP uses his legs a lot, maybe in the with the player's boot. Eichorn with the one-handed Uranagi backbreak there.
MVP reverses in the clothesline.
Now Eichorn looking to inflict some damage onto MVP, putting him in the Tree of Woe position, it seems. Booker T punches to the back of the head of Eichorn. Whoa.
Oh! Eichorn turns his attention to MVP, then gets Booker with a clothesline, and MVP there to break it up.
Interesting back and forth here tonight, and MVP with a huge German suplex.
Oh, MVP with a nice back elbow. The MVP's finally fighting now. There's a German suplex.
This is the fight we've seen of him when at one point he held the world heavyweight title